Hey guys, welcome to a brand new episode. Today I am presenting Valhalla, Floki Inu's meme token, flagship utility product. Now I've always had my reservations about meme coins. Like I've never even purchased Doge, even though, you know, from where it came from, it's done so well. Because I've always felt these coins lack utility. What can you use them for? What incentives are there to hold them? And it's nice to see a meme coin recognizing that and thinking, you know, we need to move towards giving a coin utility. And what better way to do that by creating a game? Now, when these guys approached me, so this video is sponsored by them, I have my reservations because you're going from a meme coin into a game rather than, you know, creating a game into the cryptocurrency world. But if you pay the right developers, if you get the right team on board, I think, you know, that's an absolutely fine way to do it. So I had talked back and forth and they told me about the project. This is at a very, very early stage. This was announced yesterday. And so at the moment, it is a concept. So that's what I want to look at today, is the concept of what they're trying to build. Just getting this on your guys' radar early on so that you can, you know, you can watch it as things go along, as it progresses. They are looking to have regular updates about this. But being that it is concept, always have your reservations around this. Let's, you know, I'm going to judge this and the full legitimacy of it as time progresses, as we get more, you know, if we see regular updates that have game footage. I think the trust is going to be built through that way. But at the moment, I'd say just keep this on your radar and look out for it in the future. Well, you know how we do things on this channel. It is watch to earn. And I've extended the watch to earn 10 lots of $10 given out in BNB to random people. I've extended that because we need a new system for sending out to people's wallet addresses because YouTube just deletes them. So the new way is you need to comment down below, and that way I'll use a random comment picker. And then you need to go into the Discord, and there's a tab for NFT gaming and sub-tab for wallet addresses. Post your wallet address in there and your YouTube username. Then I can draw a name, go to that, and then send it straight off to you. So if you want to be part of that, you can still have extended it. So I'll do that in the next 24 hours. You can I'll pick those 10 winners. So Valhalla, Floki Inu's flagship utility product, seeks to be the first in the crypto space to implement on-chain NFT interactions, allowing players to interact in a metaverse that pays its users for playing. Floki Inu, as part of its effort to continue to build utility to the token, has unveiled its flagship project, named Valhalla. It's an NFT metaverse run on the Floki Inu token, so it's giving that token that utility that is needed to incentivize holding. Non-fungible tokens have transitioned from being a lesser known slideshow to crypto world to becoming one of the most significant pieces of the crypto industry. One of the ways they're now the NFTs being leveraged is to give power back to gamers. Valhalla seeks to provide gamers with a fun and immersive experience that they can fully own and profit from. Valhalla is a play to earn NFT metaverse. In addition to being rewarded for battling, everything that you obtain in the metaverse is yours to own and sell as you please. The team working on Valhalla have been working on NFT games since 2017 and are at the head of development team of 15 and are onboarding high profile advisors with experience developing successful mainstream addictive games. The Floki Inu team never disappoints on development. So welcome to Floki Island, the concept. This is not the game art that you're going to be seeing in the game. From the sounds of it, what they're working towards is developing very much an Animal Crossing level of detail, top down, but good graphics that, you know, imagine this, you know, Animal Crossingified, and that's what they're aiming for. So we have, you know, Floki's ship, we have a little building, a command central, a random cave I want to explore. You as a player have just come of age. The Viking way of life begins. You begin your journey on Floki Island. The island is home to all beginning players, a few NPCs, and the following buildings. University, welcome home to Professor Musk. Bees shop for all your item needs, and the harbor where ships are docked and the starting point for raids. So very much in theme with the Viking, you know, history. is they're going to have this raiding element, the ability to raid islands for loot. In addition, the island has several wildlife areas where players can encounter certain Vera, and areas where players can make use of the guarding system. Floki Island is not the only island in Valhalla Metaverse. Vikings have to raid other islands, right? So they're going to have this command central, and then they're going to have other islands that you can go out and raid. That's where you're going to get your NFTs and rewards. Now, Vera, what are they? These are going to be like your creatures that you will encounter, very much like, you know, Pokemon style, where you're going to find them, find rare ones, train them up, and then, you know, you can battle them with them in PvP. You're in charge of your own fate. Users will be able to create their unique playable character to walk around in and interact with the world of Valhalla. To make a playable character, the user must hold a certain amount of Floki in their wallet. Players can make use of the Floki Genesis NFT collection, the collection containing bronze, silver, diamond, and ruby Floki Inu statues, to power up their player character. Ultimately, players may be able to reach Flokimandu upon collecting the entire Floki Genesis NFT collection. The economy of Valhalla runs on the Floki token. To acquire new items, potions, and crystals, players must get them at the shop, which is Bee's shop on the island, or buy them from other players. The Floki spent on items is sent towards Valhalla Treasury. Items are stored in a player travel bag and can be used while on the move in battle. So they sent details on some of the slides that we'll see in this, just so we can look at them in a bit bigger. So the Vera. Your home, Floki Island, is overrun by Vera, short for Veratil, or to be obtainable in Old Norse. Oh, I like that. I like that. Are the upgradable creatures NFTs that can be found in the world of Valhalla. Vera can be captured and or purchased from other players and can be used in game turn battling system. The world of Valhalla houses a plethora of Vera. Each Vera is available in more than 1 quadrillion variations. Players are privy to 10 unique starter Vera, and they are picked in the specific subsets of 3 by Professor Musk and presented to players. The player then decides which of the 3 Vera becomes starting companion. Additionally, there are 10 other unique Vera on the Floki Island. Of the island, you players can find 16 more unique Vera after venturing to the first raidable areas. Encounters and battles. So, mighty fantastical creatures inhabit the world of Valhalla. There's going to be variations within those. So here we can see different stats, you know, loads of different stats: rarity, personality, level, experience, species, vitality. These are going to be the things that you're going to be comparing to try and maximize to get the strongest Vera. Bee's shop will include 10 potions, 100k game treasury, 5 crystals, key items, but it's going to be limited, and you know, you are going to need more of these to be able to continue raids, and we'll talk a bit about what other ways there will be to acquire things like that. Encounters and battles, you'll have different arenas: aquatic, desert, mountainous, grassland, magma, and swamp. Different biomes, different Vera. Some areas have stronger Vera. Turn-based battle system. Experiences earned by winning battles. Earn Floki by defeating enemies and capture Vera and receive Floki rewards. So all battles occur on the on-chain, resulting in upgraded Vera NFTs post-battle. In addition, all battles have a play-to-earn mechanism where players are granted Floki after winning a battle. The battles are turn-based, where Vera takes turns performing moves from their available movesets. Players are responsible for teaching their Vera the moves they prefer and selecting the desired move per turn. So you can look at your Vera and pick the moves that you want that best work with your team. Valhalla is the first project to incorporate upgradable NFTs, all occurring on-chain. All upgradable Vera NFTs gain experience after winning a battle. Vera gain a level after a certain experience thresholds are hit, and Vera's attribute points increase after gaining a level. The number of gained attribute points depends on the base attribute values of the specific Vera, combined with its innate potential attribute values and trained attribute values. And one of the really kind of standout things of what they've said and heard from the presentation they did yesterday is that they're going to have these dynamic NFTs that change over time depending on these things that you, how you raise it. Upon achieving level 8, Vera can learn a new move. Players can pick out one of the two available choices. These choices are randomly selected from an available general move pool, and general move pools contain moves for a specific Fera type. Upon achieving level 16, Fera can once again learn a new move. Players can pick one out of two available choices, and these choices are randomly selected from available specialized move pools. Specialized move pools contain moves for a specific Fera species. I like this because it's going to mean that you need to learn what moves are good, and from that select the best ones. And it might be that to get those two moves from 8 and level 16, you have to keep raising some to get the right combination of, let's say there's two that are really good out of a pool of 10, and you only get, you know, in the first one you get option number, you get one and then a rubbish one. So you could going to pick that one, but then in 16 you might get two other rubbish ones, and you might need to go back, get another pet at a lower level, grind it up to get that perfect pet with the best traits and best abilities. Players can only capture new Vera if they have room available in their party. By default on Floki Island, the party size is 2. This means that players cannot capture new Vera if they walk around with 2 Vera. They must venture out with 1 Vera if their intention to capture a new one. Party sizes vary depending on the type of ship used to voyage to a design place. And players can't leave their Vera's NFT in a random location to remove them from their party. To remove a Vera from a player's party, they must leave it at the daycare, which is like the Professor Oak. The daycare supports 3 Vera per player by default, and the number of available slots can be increased by spending Floki. A Viking has to raid. Floki only contains a subset of all possible Vera. In addition, the Vera encountered on Floki Island are relatively weak. To find other stronger Vera, players must venture out to other parts of the world of Valhalla, and this is part of the raiding system and requires a ship to leave the island. For Gart raiding, players will need to acquire food to sustain themselves and their Vera companions. Food can be acquired at the shop or by cultivating crops through the gardening system. The amount required of food depends on a few factors. Now, what they wanted to do was account for all players. Some people might not want to go out and raid and raise Vera. Some people might just want to farm crops and use those as part of the economy to help sell to those going out to raiding. So it has this two kind of ways of playing. There is the battling, going out and raiding, and there is the farming aspect where you then go on and to sell goods that you've grown for other people who are raiding. The distance to the island, the amount of food required is based on the distance of the island to the raid, the number of companions brought along the voyage, the number of companions brought back from the voyage, and players can buy ships from the shop. Ships have 2 attributes, party space and cargo space, and you can customize your ships to show off your prowess and personality. Not all Vikings raid, some grow crops. So as mentioned, they have this gardening system. Now this is, they're doing this in collaboration with Kimball Musk's Million Gardens movement. The gardening system allows players to cultivate their crops on Floki Island. There are a multitude of available crops, not all of which are unlocked from the start. Players will be able to sow seeds and tend to their grow crops. That can be used for creation of various in-game items. If you played My DeFi Pet, you're probably used to growing crops and selling, but imagine actually getting some value out of that. My DeFi Pet doesn't place any value other than getting the silver and the food that you need to be able to level up your characters, but you can't sell that silver and you can't sell the food onto other people, but this allows you to do that. Updates will be released on a regular basis. So this is what, you know, I'm really looking to see over the next couple of months is, do they hold true to this? Are they going to regularly release updates on a regular basis? If we see this project progressing, the validity and whether this project is legit will go up. If I start to see that they're, you know, actually showing out game footage, if they're meeting the targets of what they're saying they're going to do, then the legitimacy of this increases further for me. Valhalla is currently in production. As production continues, the Floki Inu team will be releasing updates on a regular basis, which includes concept art, 3D animated visuals, and eventually gameplay footage. In addition to releasing the first version of Valhalla, the team will also be releasing updates to the game to include housing, additional raids to islands to raid, additional Vera to capture, and even player versus player battling. Please join us in our journey of creating one of the most immersive NFT metaverses in the crypto space. So this looks like it's going along the lines of kind of like your Pokemon type battling system, but with a little bit more added in terms of like the gardening, farming aspect that allows players to play in the way that they want to. So there's just a few, obviously some of these things we looked in detail. The Floki Metaverse aims to allow you to walk around, show off your Vera and gear to fellow Vikings, communicate with each other and customize your ship and be the most revered Viking of the 13 seas. So looking ahead, islands, the first priority, clans, then staking, then Jormungandr, then world raids, evolutions, seasons and days, housing, PvP, and more in the future. So this is something that is very, very early on. This is concept. This is already in production, though. You know, they've already spoken to developers, as it mentioned, teams that have been producing games for 15 years. So it's coming, but it's going to be a long wait. You know, we are over two-thirds through the year now. We've got one third left, and then 2022 is what they're aiming for this game to be, you know, fully playable. So I'll be keeping a close eye on this one and keeping you guys updated with any changes and any progressions and updates that are made within this game. If we look to the price of the token, it has had a huge, huge pump recently. So before this announcement, it did go from, you know, 0.00473 and 4x'd, even 5x'd, 6x'd at one point at its highest from this bottom. And, you know, I'm always wary about getting in after a pump that big. Even though this is some big news and gives the coin utility and incentives to hold, those incentives to hold, I don't think are here yet. Until we know exactly how much Floki token that we're going to need to hold, I'm probably going to hold off until I know that information so I can make an educated decision on that. It could pump off this news. They are obviously in contact with other YouTubers. I know some of the other YouTubers that I talk with in NFT gaming space are, you know, in talks with them as well. So we'll see what happens. At the moment, very, very, very early. You know, a lot of the projects we've covered are games that are coming within, at least in beta, in the next month. So long-term project for sure. But I think if they can deliver on everything that they're trying to do, create a game that is, you know, immersive and playable and does have this is 3D graphics. We're talking 3D animated visuals, not your 2D, which we're expected, you know, which we see a lot at the moment in battling systems like Dragonary, like my DeFi pet doesn't even have a battling system, but Axie, their aims are to create something that is not 3D. Wait, is it going to be 3D? No, my DeFi pet. So this is 3D animated visuals that we're talking about eventually in the gameplay footage, not 2D that we see at the moment in Axie, that we see in Dragonary. Things like that just don't have this typical what you'd see in a mobile game. So this game will have 3D animated visuals, which, you know, it looks like they're aiming for a game that is console playable, you know, Nintendo Switch-esque, rather than mobiles, which tend to be more 2D. So Dragonary and Axie, these 2D models, they everything works, the basics, but it's still not got that complexity of a console game. And if they can pull this off and, you know, create something that looks really good, match the visuals within Animal Crossing, this could be a really attractive and fruitful project in the future. I'll do my best to keep you up to date with this one progresses. Definitely one to keep an eye on. Okay, well, that's all for this one. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed it. If you have, please leave a like on the video. Hit subscribe if you want to keep up to date with future content and information. All the links to anything that I've talked about today is going to be in the description below. As mentioned before, the competition is still running for the Watch to Earn giveaway, where you can earn one of 10 prizes, where I'm giving $10 worth of BNB to randomly selected viewers who comment in the video and post your wallet address on Discord. Okay, that's all for this one. See you guys soon.